How you feel?
So one comment was they said something about was about Gamboa's ACL. I don't think it was the ACL, which is a knee. That's the anterior cruciate ligament. I think it was the Achilles, which he ruptured, which is right here at the back of the ankle. So that's similar to what Kobe Bryant had, Chris Webber. So these are just some football players that he had. So, and he did have it, but those are the things. So these are the things that happen once you get older. So people always kind of talk about, well, he was injured and stuff, but like, yeah, but you're more apt to get injured and pull those things and rupture Achilles once you get older. And then just a kind of a sign of that time. So that always, but I think all of that just factors into Gamboa not being a prime, you know what I'm saying? A prime fighter. Yeah. A prime fighter.
To that, I just want to add this real quick. Obviously, he had an injury during the fight. People was talking about he's trying to quit and all that. Like, Gamboa showed time and time
again. He showed heart. I give him credit.
Against Terrence Crawford, he could have quit. He fought him. He stayed down. Got up. Got put down. Got up. Like, come on, man. Gamboa, again, with Tank Davis, he literally was fighting for his life at some point because he was that hurt. So let's give Gamboa his credit. He was not looking to quit. He had a sincere injury. However, he didn't quit. Now, as far as his injury, we can't put that on Javante, like, oh, he beat an injured Gamboa. No. Because, yes, he was not the best version of Gamboa, obviously. But still, that injury occurred during the fight. It ain't like Gamboa came to the fight with an injury. It happened during the fight. Tank Davis caused that injury to take place by catching him in the second round, and Gamboa failed on his by sections in a little bit, and it caused the injury to take place. So it ain't like he came into the fight with an injury. Nah, Tank Davis caused the injury. So yeah, maybe Gamboa would have fought better without the injury, obviously. But still, it was Tank Davis that caused that to happen. It's like when Pacquiao fought Bradley. He had Timothy Bradley circling around, not knowing what's happening. He ended up twisting his feet. You know, That's credit to Pacquiao footwork. So it's credit to Javante Tank Davis footwork because he landed it beautifully without even trying. And that's why I say Javante at his best, he's a problem. And shout out to Gamboa because that's one of my favorite fighters of all time. He sent me a shirt. He sent me a signed glove. All these champions, all these legendary Cuban fighters, even Regan Diaz. So I just want to point that out. Gamboa, obviously, it's like watching Roy Jones when Roy Jones started getting knocked out. That's not the Gamboa that is really the baby Tyson.
Facts.
And the guy that came to the scene and blasted the scene and had everybody avoiding him. Now, on to the next topic. Man, my man, Badu Shaq, he cannot. Very, very good show, guys, from Bernard. Appreciate it, everybody. Tune in, Split Decision next show. We're going to have better quality. We just working as we go because at the end of the day, we ain't missing no show. Regardless of whether it is every Sunday, tune in. Y'all could count on us being here regardless of what's happening. I had a wedding to go to, but at the end of the day, guess what? I still showed up right after the wedding. You know, even though I was looking for the second and third and fourth wife, you know how I go. But at the end of the day, I come back to Split Decision. So you can watch me on Split Decision. How about that? So, appreciate everybody. Appreciate you, Professor Nim. Don't ever leave me lonely again. I was over here singing Mr. Lonely by Akon. I like Mr. Lonely. I got nobody on Split Decision. Like, I'm over here hustling on my own. Man, you had me multitasking. You had me all over the place. But it's all right. My man back. He back on the map. He back on, like Lil Baby said. And obviously, A-Rap Baby in the house. I got my man A-Rap Baby coming. The merch coming. Split Decision coming. All of that. So cop the merch, call in, tune in, click on the like button, click on the notification bell to get notified every time we post to go live. And obviously, if you want to graduate from the Aki University, then take y'all notes. Y'all going to learn something every day and become hardcore boxing fans. So I appreciate every single one of y'all. I appreciate all the support. I appreciate everybody from the super chat to the comment section to the likes to the views. To the people that ask, that call in or ask or whatever. Even the haters, man. Because the haters, they your biggest fans, exactly. Right?
And you got to leave them if you want to get dumb about it. What?
Oh, you already know. Subscribe below if you're trying to get smart about them. And if you're trying to get dumb about a second, don't. And listen to these old media or casual fans. And appreciate it, Professor.
All right, man. We out, man. Hey, Happy New Year to everybody out there. Peace.
Peace. And you already know, you know, at the end of the day, huh? You already know how we come.
Ew. I don't even know how.